walking down the street, concentrating on trucking right. I heard a dark voice beside.
Well, guys, it's Saturday, 28th October. And I've been back from Rainbow just a week. In fact, I spoke with Eric and Stuart, who took over from us. And, yeah, it was quite a fairly quiet week for them. I think Stuart had three, Eric had four. And I think Lockie had maybe a couple. Dave Wibley had three or four, I think. So, yeah, fairly quiet. But I think Kev the Lady had a 70. Paul on the Island had a 60. Who else? Jordan, he had a 70. So there was some good fish out, but I think it was a quieter week this week than the week I was on. But anyway, right now, I'm off to Parco del Brenta in the morning. I'm flying down from Stansted. Graham and Spud picked up my gear yesterday. They're driving down, so they've gone down in convoy with the Hertfordshire boys, Clayton, Nick, and all their lads. So tomorrow morning, I catch up with three guys at the airport. We fly down. And we're fishing Sunday to Sunday. I fished Parco last year. It's a great water. It's in northern Italy. And again, it's a bit like fillet. It's a runs water, if you're lucky, with biggins. So there's 16 of us fishing, which is quite a lot for the size of the lake, but that is what it is. We'll be having a draw tomorrow. And yeah, watch this space. As I say, great lake, well run by Nicholas. Some beautiful fish in it, and yeah, look forward to spending a week with you know, a great bunch of lads, some of whom I've fished with before. So right now, just skirting about. As I say, all I've got to do is take some hand luggage on the plane tomorrow, and next time the video comes out, we'll probably be at Stansted, catching up with the lads, having breakfast, and then I think a 2.5 hour flight, and we're there. Compared with, I think it's about of, I think it's about an 18 hour journey. Door to door from home, but as I say, the boys, the bulk of the boys, having driven down, you know, have taken the gear. We can share the costs between us, and yes, it makes a lot of sense. So as I say, looking forward to the week ahead. Let's see how we get on.
Journey.
How long we got?
Yes.
Sound like my mum.
Yes. Don't worry, guys, I'll carry my own gear.
Yes. We're looking after you, aren't we, Abel?
Well, it's 10:45 Sunday morning, and that just could not have been easier. Flight was on time, in fact, it was early. We've been here. It's a beautiful day. The guys who were here last week had it off in pegs 15, 17, I think. Loads of fish. So there's a lot of anglers on here last week. But right now, I'm going to have a little skirt about. The boys are walking about themselves. And, yeah, looking forward to the week ahead. So I'm in peg one now, which is out on a point. Just scanning around the lake. So there's peg two down there. There'll be peg three there. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 over there, and that starts to go in the bay. There's 18, there's 20, I think. So just scanning around here. And this is a bay area, I think, peg 22 up here. But right now, we're just getting our bearings. And then we'll have our draw, and everyone's probably already got their ideas of where they want to fish and stuff, but there's been fish out all over today. There's a lot of fish in here. I guess it's a case of getting in an area where most fish are and then fishing it well. So, yeah, we'll see.
So, Clay, talk to me. Now you're so photogenic with your beard and everything.
I'm warmer,
else.
A lot warmer.
Yeah. So you've done all the arranging of this trip, Clay. Well done.
Never again.
Yeah. Never. Yeah, no, I know you mean that.
Felt like a babysitter on the way down.
Yeah.
So you all drove down early hours yesterday morning.
Yeah, don't go through Switzerland.
Why?
We got stopped by customs and they just kept us waiting. And
but you look the type to be kept waiting, Clay.
Well,
yeah?
it was probably the drugs and the guns we were trying to get in.
I have actually got a gun.
I bet you have got
it. I have.
Well, anyway, I'll edit that bit out. Yeah. So, Clay, what's our plans this week then? Talk to the camera briefly.
Right, the plans this week, we're going to have our draw now and get set up and hopefully catch loads of fish. It's been hard this week. Quite a few fish have come out of 17, 16 and 15. There's been about 150 fish. 15 have had two anglers in it, 17 and 16 have done that. So they've been up in that bay basically. But I can't believe with the stock of fish in here that they're not everywhere else. It's just, oh, here we go.
Yorkshire boys coming from behind. Right, let's get a three of you together. Look at that.
Do you realise how long it's taken Clayton to work this draw formula out? He's had to ring old Stephen Hawkins up.
And I'm still I'm still confused at it. If I
it's quite simple, Kev. Even a simpleton like you must be able to work this out. We'll talk you through it, don't worry.
Right, okay, yeah. Right, cool.
Whatever happens, you probably come out near the bottom.
Yeah,
I would say dead bottom.
Yeah.
The way we've rigged the balls. Because what it is, you're going to have to stand on a box to get your hand right in there. And we're not going to give you the box.
What, you saying I'm short?
No. Well,
I'm just saying you're vertically challenged.
We've weighted all the balls, and we've left one light one. Yeah. So you'll only be able to reach the top ball.
Always.
Easy.
Right.
That's it.
And that's the last one.
No, that's the first one. You're drawing first.
So we're all standing here. That's where we're having the draw. That's the point I walked out on with the boys. So, Rich, you're going for your early morning run, are you? Early morning swim.
I've already been,
Kev. You put on weight, haven't you?
No, not too much.
No, yeah, you look like you have, you put on at least a stone.
Sticky Beaks Farm Australia, Rob! Sticky Beaks
Farm! Boys, isn't
it? That ain't a full ticket, then, right, eh? What do you fancy then, Rich? What's your plans?
Well, obviously, there's a few hot swims which I've been catching, so it'll be nice to get one of them, but just play it by ear, really, see what I get.
And what sort of rigs and bait approach have you got? Or should we save that for when I come round?
We'll save that for when I come round, but they reckon the bait boat, as the fish are taking it on the drop, so within about 5 minutes. So, you got to try that approach to start with and then see how it goes, really. Maybe not too much bait to start with, and then put it in once you start having it.
Right, okay. I don't know yet.
No.
Explain everything how it goes. This is Clayton's sorted all this out and asked me to convey it to you lot. Right? Yeah. Okay. So basically, we're gonna have a draw. There's 10 balls in the bag because there are 6 pairs and 4 singles. Yeah. So 10 balls in there. So you take a ball and then afterwards, everybody's got the balls. Then we'll sort out the swims after that. Now the basic format for the swims are: every swim is open. You can go where you want to go. Right. But if you're a pair. Right, and you get swim 6, you have to have 6 and 7.
Yes.
Yeah, and right. If you're a pair and you have swim 8, you have to have 8 and 9. Yeah, okay? Right, enough, yeah. Now, if you're a single when you pull 6, you've got to expect somebody to drop into 7.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you're a single when you pull a swim, right, then you've got to expect somebody can drop in next year. They can't drop in the same swim, but they can drop in next year.
Yeah.
Right? If you've got a spare swim next year, you're perfectly willing to chuck rods in that water. But if anybody else wants to move in next to you, you've then got to move your rods back out again. Yeah. So effectively, you can pull where you want, okay? We all know where's fishing well, we all know where we want to go. I think that's basically what we wanted to say, isn't it? The only other thing, I know we talked about boats. All I would say about boats is you can use boats and bait boats, they're in the rules, it's all fine. You must wear a life jacket, but please try not to be excessive with either, and please try and keep in your own water, because we want to keep it diplomatic, gentlemen, if that's all right. Brad, you good?
Yeah. So we now do the draw. Well explained, Nick. I still don't understand it, but well explained.
Is that a heavy one?
I've got a blank one. I've got the lucky ball.
Can't tell you yet.
I'm right. Not good.
Can't tell you.
I'll show you my balls.
Oh, you want 10 and 11, yeah?
10 or 10 and 11. Oh, what do you reckon?
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. How comes we can have 10 and 11 or 9 and 10? How does that work?
No, you've got 9 and 8 and 9.
8 and 9 or 10 and 11.
Sorry.
So you're either in the bay and that.
Or 10 and 11, I reckon.
It's all that area there.
So you're going 10 and 11?
I don't know, what do you reckon?
You've got all the dead bay here, haven't you?
Where's your ball going?
Then you control that, haven't you?
Just, 8 ain't really got that much.
I don't care.
Whereas like 10 you can go.
Are you going to go 8 and 9? If we go 10 and 8, that's their water. So you're just straight out in front of you.
No, we're not.
And that's right, isn't it?
Well, this is a huge decision.
Yeah, because all the best ones are gone, that's right.
Bit there.
Well, if you go in the middle here, you've got out to that plateau and start straight out in the middle. Come on, you've got to find up.
Do whatever, 10 and 11, yeah?
It's up to you.
That's Gary and Mark.
What have you chosen? It's about an hour since.
Who's got number five?
What you got?
Who's number five?
We've got 10 and 11, mate. 10 and 11.
So it's late morning now, Sunday. We had the draw. It was good fun. And to be fair to Clay, Nick and the boys, well organised. So right now, I'm in peg 14. I come out fourth. And in truth, I would have picked the swim. Spud always picks number one out. Well done to Spud. So he's picked 17 and 18 with G. We'll catch up with him. The boys in 15, they were out third. Clay was out second. He picked the peg one, the long point. But as I say, I'm happy. And yeah, just to have a quick word with the lads. So boys, you drove down yesterday, come together like Thompson twins. Come down together yesterday, set out early morning. Give me a brief synopsis of the drive.
Really, really easy. Could not have been any easier if we tried. Going through Switzerland is totally jaw-dropping. The beauty of the place, it has to be seen to be believed. Inspiring, absolutely inspiring. But yeah, very easy journey. Dropped a pin on the sat-nav, took us straight here, no problem whatsoever. Tank, under a tank and a half of diesel. So we'll be lighter on the way back. Fantastic.
And you drove all the way, Spud?
Yep,
and
954 mile.
Is that what it was, door-to-door,
yeah? Yep, door-to-door, 954 miles. Motorway most of the way. Obviously got stuck in a little bit of traffic coming up the tunnels and that lot going through Switzerland. Other than that,
right, and you
couldn't
picked
go wrong.
17 and 18 between you,
picked
which are the hot pegs,
18.
Good call. Done. I think most people, number one out of the draw, would have picked those.
Done 72 fish last week.
Yeah.
Admittedly, they had about 20 small ones between them. But
even so, a lot of fish.
Of fish, so.
All right, well, boys, you've dropped me off, yeah?
Yeah.
We'll have a busy day today. I'll probably catch up with you at some stage tomorrow.
Yep.
And, yeah, thanks for bringing my gear down and
good luck.
Yeah?
No worries. Best of luck
to yourself. You too. Yeah, come around and get your tactics, yeah? Yeah. Cheers, boys. Yeah? Have a good one. Yeah?
I will do.
All right, boys.
Yeah, I'll sling it up and come and get you.
If you get a big one, Spud, get me, yeah?
Yeah, I will do. Oh, mate. Kev.
Well, it's 3 o'clock. I ain't quite at that cup of tea moment, but I've got me three rods out, and I was, as I said earlier, I'm in peg 14 and I come out fourth and I'm happy. I've got no one to my left. I'm in a bay. I've got features in front of me in terms of, I think, what was a sort of road when they built it. So we'll have a little skirt round. Place looks like a pigsty right now, but I'm going to tidy up and group for the evening. Richard's fishing next to me in 13. You've got Pugwash over there in 1 and there, that's peg 1. So I'm using my bait boat with a fish finder just for the depths and so forth. I've got one rod down in the margin, one over there, one over there. So that's broadly it. You've got 6 metres going up to some features in front of me here. Sort of 2.5 metres over in the corner in the shallows. But yeah, plenty to go at just out here. But you cannot ignore these margins, as I know from last year. Got Graham and Spud over there in 17 and 18. There's no one opposite me, thankfully. No one there. And as I say, that's Clayton, by the looks of things, out in his boat. Well, Nick and Bill, round the corner to us. I think they've only been out a couple of hours. We've all only had our rods out maybe an hour or two. And they've had a fish almost straight away. So, let's go around and have a look, see what they got. This is Richard, fishing to my right. Yeah, go around and see what the boys have got. Yeah, Richard's in 13. So he's to my right. There's the boys in 1 over there. Yeah, so Nick and Bill are in peg 9. Got this half of the lake to themselves.
Here we are in peg 9, Kev.
Pay attention, Bill.
I'm paying attention, look.
Yeah?
Right, come to your left a bit.
You got back leads on, Bill?
Yeah, back leads,
what,
mate.
Captive back there? Oh, yeah, normal back leads, yeah.
Slide down. Yeah. Right. Just come slightly to your left, as you are, straight you are.
Boys have got an RV4 set up between them. which means you can get the bed chairs front to back, unlike mine, because it's 2.4 deep as well as 2.4 across, whereas mine's 2.4 across and 2 metres deep. So for anyone interested in these, the RV4, as I say, lets you get bed chairs in front to back.
Can't be
that, mate. It's a good spot. This is the boys' mix
here. We've got 25 foot. There's no fluffing counters.
Am I in your way, Nick?
No, go on, you're good.
No, it's all good, Kev. I always look better on video than photos, to be fair.
Yeah. I'm on it.
Here she goes.
Well done, Bill. First fish of the trip. Nice one.
Pleased with that.
Yeah, I bet you are. Result.
My first Italian carp.
What we'll do, Bill, we'll celebrate that with a nice dinner, all of us.
Yeah, Richard.
Yeah. Whose turn is it tonight, Rich?
Yeah, I'll cook tonight.
Ah, lovely. Well done, boys.
Done it.
I'll do the tea all week.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do the dinners.
And I'll do the healthy pastas.
Yeah,
tuna
happy
pastas.
Days. Show us your six-pack, Rich.
Ooh, oh, not now. Your secretary might get a bit...
Yeah, he's got one, I've got one.
I've got two.
Yeah. Oh, it was nice to see that fish. Beautiful scale, perfect common. So, yeah, nothing like a fish to... on the bank to get you going, that's for sure. I think it's about 7 o'clock now, Monday morning. I saw a picture of it on Facebook. Yeah. No, welcome to the day though, Nick. Yeah, you look lovely. How'd you get on, buddy?
Nothing.
No, and we didn't, but we heard fish.
Yeah.
He thought they were down to my left, I think, you know, between me and Rich.
Yeah? Last night. There were loads of fish down our end. Not caught anything at all. I was up until about 3:30 this morning watching them, just boshing one after another, and they were all the way through. I think
it might be some, maybe like a zig rig or something later.
Zig's a band, can't put that on here.
I know.
Where were you?
We're gone, I ain't coming back again.
You and the boys are just saying, yeah, it's yeah, one of the lads in 22, he had a 60 and a 50 in the night. A couple have been lost. Don't know what else is happening. There was a 50 out as well. Spud had a 40. But yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's a bit weird. I was expecting to get some fish. And Richard's come up this morning. He thought they were to my left. I'm thinking they were between me and him. So anyway, let's have a cup of tea. Always makes the world a much better place, cup of tea. Well, it's mid-morning Monday. I come round to see the boys, and you know what? They kindly, Spud and Graham, who picked out number one, doubled up in 17, left 18 free, and kindly invited me to fish in there. I think they invited me, or I might have invited myself, I'm not too sure. But anyway, I can fish a couple of rods the area I was fishing from 14, and then I'm going to fish a couple of margin rods. So anyway, I've got all the gear around in Spud's van. Just going to skirt about, have a bite to eat. I'm starving. And nice to be fishing with the lads. Bit more social, but also, yeah, very good swim. So, Spud's had three now. The boys in 15 have had two or three. As I say, in 22 they've had a couple. But early doors yet. But yeah, let's get plotted up and... I'll get the video out when that cup of tea moment comes up. Yeah, loading the barra and handballing it, because you can only bring the van so far. That's about 150 yards up there. But I'm excited and I'm on a mission. Well, it's just before 12 o'clock. That was a hectic few hours. I'm rounding peg 18, got my rods out, and fishing alongside G and Spud. So glad to be round here. I'll have a quick look round the swim. Here's the rods. I've got one in the margin down here, one out there, third of the way, one over there, and that was 14 where I was fishing earlier. There's Richard over there. Clayton, he lost one earlier, cut him off on that road thing, so there's peg one over there. And this is the scene, as I say, nearly midday on Monday. All to play for now. Feel good, feel grouped. There's 15 where I fished last year.
and here's Spud and G that have doubled up. It's a long drop, dropping your bait boat down there. It's quite precarious. So Graham's set up here with Spud in 17, and they're catching the fish over on that far margin. And then you've got the Driscoll brothers down there in 16. We'll catch up with them later. So a cup of tea, boys. Bit of lunch. Jobs are good, aren't they?
Yes.
Monday afternoon, Spud just rebaited, went almost immediately. Nice one, Spud, get it back.
Oh, just sat there being solid.
He's yours. Nicely done, G.
Smashed it, mate.
Look at that.
Fucking smashed it. Well done. Right.
Well done, Spud. Good angling, buddy.
Cheers, mate.
Yeah, well done.
Set a shoulder. Lift it onto this.
Driscoll brothers coming up for a look.
If we get one, I need you do the middle bit.
Gold.
Yeah. Hold on, let me just check the fin.
It's another beast, isn't it? So that's 69 pound. Less than, is that including the sling or?
No, sling's already off.
Sling's off. 69 pound.
On the nose.
69 on the nose. Bang on the nose.
Cheers, guys. PB.
Well done, Spud.
Oh, I'm bringing the rod in a minute. I'm going up supermarket to get some beers.
Yes.
Well done, Spud.
Cheers,
well
Kev. Done, thank you very much.
Where did you run off that far? What you've been taking the bait boat over to?
Oh, mate.
Beautiful. Heavy? You're shaking.
Oh, mate, yeah.
I wouldn't know how heavy they are, but they look heavy.
Oh, yeah.
Just lovely to see, but
it is when it's a good mate and all.
Yeah.
There you go,
my lovely.
Well done, Spud. How's great it, angling. Mate? Well played. Yeah, how's that feel?
What's he feel like? Superb, I'll buy all the beers tonight.
What? I will buy the beers for the rest of the week. That is blinding.
Rolling tonight.
That fucking is... the rods in. Come on, let's go.
Take that, Mark. Heads off slip. Yeah,
that is a fish of a lifetime. First time in Italy. Can't ask for much more. Superb.
What a super fish that was. 69 pound. Cracking fish. Well played by Spud as well. It looked like it was snagged at one stage. Kept the pressure on and luckily it come off. But you could see it was a good fish by the way it was boiling and so forth. So it's now Monday evening. Well, I won't be far off before it's dark. What's it now? Probably about 5:30 latest, I think. Maybe a bit earlier. But, that's certainly got us all going, that's for sure.
Don't deploy until I say it drop.
Well, it's nearly lunchtime, Tuesday. Been up for a shower. Spud went up to the supermarket. I did a bit of office work, clear me head. Right now, I'm climbing the walls. I know we're only two nights in, but the amount of fish last night in front of Spud and G, which is just around the corner of me, was astonishing. But they didn't get anything during the night. Spud has been getting the bites during the day. I didn't have a bite. I'm not sure what happened on the rest of the lake. I think Nick had a 40, and the Driscolls, they had a 40 each. So there are fish trickling out, but not a lot by Parco standards. Right now I don't feel like I can buy a bite. So, and I'm not inclined to even change tactics. I don't know what to do. If I was going to change, I'd need a reason for changing. Well, the reason for changing is I ain't catching. But what would I change to? I'm, confident in what I'm doing. So right now, I'm disappearing up my backside. I'm going to have a cup of tea, have some lunch with the boys. And, have a bit of a rethink. But right now, I need a fish. Let's go and see Spud. It's just before lunchtime Tuesday. He's just baiting up, having got back from the supermarket. have a look at your tactics, bud. So you've got a little method feeder there, some scalded pellet.
Yeah.
And what's your bait, spud? A little
trim down
dumbbell copper. On a small hook. Was it size 6 hook?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you're baiting up with maize.
And then I'll show you as I go through.
Pellets.
Mines in each one. Green beast, dumbbells, 18 mils.
Yeah, you like this cold water green beast, don't you?
Right, it works all year round.
Yeah.
Superb bait for winter.
You've been using it a while, haven't you?
Been using it for the last 3 years.
Yeah, unmistakable flavour, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, black. Is it blackberry?
Yeah.
Yeah. And there's bumbleberry also from DT. So that's what you've been putting out, Spud, last couple of days, yeah?
Yep. Not a lot. I'm literally just putting enough out there to try and nick a bite. I don't see, well, I haven't needed to put heavy amounts of bait out yet, so I'm just going to keep going down.
It's astonishing the amount of fish there last night, wasn't it? But yeah. It's funny how you're not getting bites at night.
This bay, every night so far I've been here, literally all night, bosh, 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 all night. But don't get a take.
Yeah.
But and then it is 23 foot in the middle, 19 foot this edge, and then it goes up to 7 foot on the far bank. So they're boshing on the top and you're fishing 23 foot under them. Just one of them.
And zig rigs are banned.
Yeah, zig rigs, surface fishing banned. Otherwise, yeah, I would have a lot of zigs out at night.
Well, mid-afternoon now, regrouped. Changed me spots on two rods. Just to give me a different area, really. I haven't heard anything out here last night, but just got to make a change, really, for change's sake, because I ain't cool. I think that's the right phrase, you know. I'll go through my tactics later in the week, but right now, if the fish ain't here, you ain't going to get them. And if they ain't here in the next day or so, you know, I feel like I'll need to move. But I don't know. I don't know whether I'm coming or going right now. I just need a fish. I think that's what I need, a fish. Yeah, G's in, having just put them out. Tuesday afternoon, nice one. One, G. Well done. Let me done.
Case
in. Not
a bad one.
How many?
Need a fucking sleep
after.
Not a bad one.
Cool.
That's a fucking
cracker,
mate.
30.
35. 35 and a half.
Yeah, 35 and a half.
Well done.
Happy
mate.
With that?
Yeah, well done, fella.
First fish is always most important. Jeez.
Well done, G.
Well happy with that. Boys. Cheers.
Alright. Well done, G. That app on the phone, geez, brilliant, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so clear, it makes life so much easier.
So it won't be long before it's dark now, Tuesday evening. G lost one earlier and had one, so he's off the mark, just rebaiting up. And I need to get one. It's a Tuesday night, just doing dinner in G's bivvy. Burger, chips and salad.
Well, that was a cutaway shot of my landing net in the sunrise Wednesday morning. Look at them fish jumping. My landing net thinks it's in a new close season because I can't buy a bite. And last night, between us, we couldn't buy a bite. And around here, in 17 and 16, I can't tell you how many fish we heard. And in fact, they're still jumping now. I'll try, yeah, look, look. It's mad. Let's try and capture some fish moving. Unbelievable. The boys didn't get a bite. It's got to happen during the day. They're just not having it at night. They're just jumping. I don't know what it is. But nothing moving in front of me. Well, it's 8:30. Was it Wednesday morning? And yeah, I honestly really don't know what to do. You know, I'm going to move one of my rods on a spot, but I don't know whether I'm just creating more food around and creating too many spots. I'm searching for the fish, and equally, I'm not afraid to move. You know, I've moved once, you know, within 24 hours. I'm happy to move again, but I don't know where to move to. You know, it's just one of them. I don't know whether the temperature drop has affected the fish. It's certainly slower this week than last week. Might be something to do with it, but right now, I can't buy a bloody bite. So, Spud, with the amount of fish moving out here last night, you must have been expecting some fish.
I was, yeah. There's every single night in this bay, there is literally from about 10 o'clock till about 4 o'clock in the morning, it's non-stop. But just not getting takes. They all seem to be mid-water and up, and it just, to me, it just don't make sense. They're literally bossing straight over the top of your baits, and you're just not getting takes.
G?
Yeah.
Yeah, G. Was you hearing the fish or was you sleeping?
Oh, I could hear the fish, all right. It was keeping me well awake.
Unbelievable, the amount
most of
fish
the night, out. But they're right under the rod tips. But again, they're all upper layers, maybe 2-3 feet under the surface, and you're fishing in 18-19 foot of water. Real big shame we can't use zigs, but it is what it is, you know. We'll just have to try and do what we can, you know, see what happens.
Gotta say that Raymarine graphic on the Navigator bait boat is something else. Best graphic I've seen on a bait boat, that's for sure. And yeah, the boys are using it on their phone as an app as well. So yeah, we'll have a quick look.
Where the bait's just dropped out of the boat. There.
Yeah.
Bait's dropped out
and these are fish.
Circled it and come back. Yeah, these are all
fish.
Fish,
yeah, look at that, yeah. Yeah, it's breakfast time and do you know what? I'm disappearing up my backside. Yeah, time to regroup. Got 4 nights to make it happen and I'm going to make it happen. Not quite sure what to do, but I'm going to make it happen. What I'm going to make happen, I'm still not sure about, but I'm going to make it happen. Yeah, the scene mid-morning on Wednesday. Yeah, boys have been doing well over in 15. Yeah, the boys are just having a little search around my swim over the back there. Again, with a Raymarine, and I'll just be interested to see what it says over there versus how detailed my Lawrence one is. Yeah, just having a play around with G's boat there, looking at the area I was fishing from 14, and it was pretty much as I mapped it myself. So I'm just going to have a slight change of position. Well, not a slight change, a big position on a couple of my rods. I'm coming out of the deeper water. I'm going over the back there. And but you've got to fish it in such a way, you've probably got to fish it locked up, even though you're in open water there, because you don't want the fish going the other side of the bar, because then you'll have a sod of a job getting them back over. So the idea is that I'm going to fish in that shallower water on the bar, fish locked up so that when I get a bite, I'm not giving it loads of line, it can dive over and then, you know, you're on your back foot. That's the plan anyway. Got to get a bite first, but in preparation of the bite, which I'm going to get, because I've got to think like that, got to think positive, making sure I can then, walk backwards almost. So whilst you're in open water, it's like snag fishing. I think that makes sense, not too sure. Do you know what, on that note, last night, I'm going to get the angliest game one day. I was having line bites on my right-hand rod. So no sooner I have a line bite, got back in the bag. A few minutes later, another line bite. Oh my God. So I'm standing by the rods just to see what the indicator does. About the fourth time this was, 3 o'clock this morning, freezing cold, mist everywhere. Only to realise it's a rat running through and hitting me danglers. Yeah, I'll learn one day, I'm sure. We're yet to have breakfast. I'm stuck. Guys, if we don't hurry up and eat, I think Bob Geldof's going to call another Live Aid. Because I'm that hungry.
I have to say, Kev, you're looking a bit emaciated lately.
Jeez, in not having long rebaited Wednesday morning.
That's a cool go. Probably is.
Nicely done, G. Just baited up that one, didn't you?
Yeah, it's been out about 20 minutes or so. Buttercorn goo pop up. Little white 15mm on some Nutty Crunch. Main boilies with some pellets, again with Nutty Crunch. Thing from Vital Baits. Happy done.
Twisting that line. Hold on. I need to walk them out. Twisting.
Here come the Driscoll brothers.
Half?
40
and a half.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well done, G.
Thank you very much.
Well done, mate. Well done. Yeah, first one.
Good man.
Yeah.
That's so many. Hair transplant clinic.
Yeah, he's got a hair, doesn't he? One or two.
One or two.
That's not many.
You need a Rooney.
That's a bit red.
It needs a bit of goo on there, doesn't it? Get you going.
Yeah.
£40 eight.
Guys, what occurs on tour and all that, I'm going to have my picture taken with it, just in case. Yeah, G, don't put it back just yet. I could do him a picture taken, look like I caught one.
That found it. Which has got bumbleberry goo in it.
Alright.
And then a corn.
Teasing again, approaching lunchtime Wednesday. A lot of fizzing going on over there, weren't there, Spud?
Oh, mate, it's like a jacuzzi, look. Still see it.
Well done, G.
Thank you.
Yeah, superb.
Number two. Number three of the session, number two today.
Yeah, good for you. Well done, mate.
In the space of about, 10 minutes?
10 minutes, yeah. The bait went out with the boat. Just turned it into a call. It's still fizzing out there now. Over where number one rod was, but unfortunately this one managed to take it out, but hey-ho.
All go, G, innit? Hey, all go.
Hey, but all the best way though, Kev.
Superb.
On the nose.
£31. Well done.
Thank you very much. Get some shots.
£48 on the nose.
Yeah.
Well done, mate.
Yeah, nice one. Yeah, well chuffed. Caught a fish. Yeah, early hours of Thursday morning, is it? Yeah, early hours of Thursday morning, yeah. £48 early hours of Thursday morning, my first fish. Much needed, let me tell you. Well chuffed with that. Ready to get the outside. Well, if ever I needed a fish, it was that one. I'm well chuffed with that, let me tell you. It's actually, I think it was just before midnight Wednesday I caught that, so yeah, had it on for about 15 minutes. It's now about, what is it, about 1 o'clock Thursday morning. So yeah, going back to bed, at me man, I'm freezing out there. Spud got me jacket because I was shivering. So it's one thing, sleeping almost naked. Where was I? But yeah, when you get to run, it's handy having someone putting a coat round you, let me tell you. So anyway, can I lay on the bed, contemplate that fish, and yeah, relieved is the word. Well, Thursday morning, and it makes for a much brighter morning when you've had a fish in the night, that's for sure. Well, I just got up, need a cup of tea. And you know what, I'm pleased to have had that fish, don't get me wrong, but you know what, should be catching a lot more. Should be catching a lot more. So anyway, let's have a cup of tea and start thinking about the day ahead. Well, I've been for a shower, and whilst lying in bed last night, I was thinking of what I might change or what I might do. And in fact, when I wound in one of my rods, which is on the corner opposite me, there's obviously some trailing line there and stuff. I've got to steer away from that because I've picked that up on the way back. But yeah, I've also got a margin rod really close in, as has clay, which hasn't done anything. So I'm going to put that out a bit further. But anyway, right now, time for a couple of cups of more tea, some breakfast, and yeah, and I'm going to take off the unleaded leader, which is only about 3 foot long, and put a nylon one on. But anyway, we'll cover rigs later on in the week. Right now, yeah, skirt about and ought to play for. Got a spring in my step now, that's for sure. Well, we're all just rebaiting up. G and Spud had gone up the supermarket. No sooner they got the bait back out, Jesus turned, tore off.
About 2 minutes.
Yes, boys were saying last week they was getting bites on the drop.
Yeah, literally, we found the fish on the sonar, dropping it right in their heads, and within a couple of minutes they're going off.
Wow.
If you get it right.
Spud, while he's playing that fish, you ain't had a bite for a couple of days.
No.
He started off well on the right, now yep. The left's taken over.
Yes. Yeah.
Why is that, do you think?
I think at night time, they're either pushing in or pushing out of the bay along the far margin, and then obviously as they're coming back in, as it's starting to warm up, geez, they're picking them up before they get across the mine. But good on him. It's one of them.
Yeah, I think the ducks might have scared the fish or whatever, because it was down here, and now it's out. Happy days. You've been complaining about the ducks all week.
Yeah, not sure what words G was muttering there, but the fish is snagged in the margin. It's kited round to the right. So, yeah, it's one of them situations you're never sure what best to do. Pull, let it go slack, dive in. Well, yeah, we'll see what happens.
Darren's kindly come round from 15 in his boat, try and help G. It looked a good fish, according to G. G, Spud, you might be better off controlling the boat.
Who are you then?
I've never felt anything like that in my line before. That was absolutely like playing a sack of coal.
A lump?
Yeah.
I've lost three.
Darren, I thoroughly appreciate you coming
over.
No, that's fine, bud, that's fine.
Shame, G, that's fishing, mate.
Hey, yeah. C'est la vie.
Yeah.
They're still out there. We'll have another one.
That was massive.
You had a good
the way that yeah. went, G. Yeah, it's a shame for G. We've all been there. And they did look a good fish, unfortunately. Although, you know, I've said it
10 times on these videos, and I have to quote Lockie because it's just the perfect quote. Mark, what fish sticks in your mind most that you lost? His answer, all of them. And it occurs to me every time I do a video, that quote. Yeah, and it sticks with me because that is how it is. You know, you never know what you lose, but that's fishing, and we come for all the thrills and the fun and the disappointments, and it all adds up. But so yeah, disappointing for G, that's for sure. Well, this is the scene, lunchtime now, Thursday, three nights to go, and I'm proper fired up. Regrouped, changed tactics slightly, I'm on it.
Bring your number one rod in.
Yeah. Well done, G.
That's a shame it wasn't the first one, but never mind.
Nice one, G. How big?
29 pounds, 8 ounces. A little above the 30, but. Guess it's nice to get one of the bank today. Lost the first one, bit upset about that, didn't play it very well, really my fault, but hey, you learn for next time.
Sounds like G's got a nice one. What you got there, bud? Let's have a look,
mate. That's a PB, mate. That's a fucking, I smashed it, PB, mate.
Oh, well done, that's a super fish.
Well,
well done, G. Well done, PB.
Frame on it.
Happy days. Your PB was a mirror at Rainbow, was it?
Yeah, PB was a mirror from Rainbow Swim 8 2005.
Yeah,
October
well
2005. So
yeah, super fish.
Yeah,
need
come all the way to Italy for a wonderful new fish. Magic.
Straight down the deeps.
How good was that, G?
Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
G is absolutely over the moon with that fish, as he should be. That's what fishing's all about. Both him and Spud have had PB so far this week. Fantastic. About an hour after the last one, £30 on the nose. Well done, G. This is where Graham's getting them. Spud, it's uncanny how even on your left-hand rod you're not getting a bite.
The thing is, G's not getting one on his left, he's not getting one on his right. It's that single rod on that same spot every time. But...
How big, G?
£37 on the nose. Well pleased.
G, red letter session, buddy. Oh, you must be well pleased with that, the action you're getting, eh?
Oh, can't put it to words, Kev. Oh, absolutely brilliant. Very tiring, though. When you're a big ugly geezer like me, believe me, this is hard frigging work.
Yeah, no, but good game.
Hey, how pleasurable.
Yeah,
how pleasurable.
Fishing well. Yeah, keep going.
Thank you very much.
Come look at the rigs, bud. We have no secrets on these videos.
Right.
Come and get this, have a look at the rigs. Method feeder. What's that? A crank hook.
Size 4 Continental.
Hold on, let me have a look at it. Oh, size 4 Continental.
6 Continental.
Size 6 Continental.
With a wide trim down wafter on it.
What's on the edge, bud?
Nothing.
Well, I don't think the boys can keep two rods in the water. Spud's moved his one now to the left near G. He's had a bite. I was saying, I'm going to get the video because someone's going to get a bite any second, and at that point it's tore off.
See, yeah, I've got the... That's a bite, G. Yeah,
yeah. One of Kev's, I reckon.
One of mine? I'm thinking all three of mine.
Poacher.
Aye. How do they get under the old rock, don't they?
Oh, it's bad.
Is it? Yes.
We're in, innit?
Well, our second one I've got to take on video, Spud.
Good. Well done, son.
Well done, boys.
We're sorting it now.
So Spud weighed his 25 pound common. This is G's.
So 31 pound, just about 31 and a quarter.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, well done.
Well done, mate. 42.
12,
yeah, yeah. About 41, 12, yeah.
Well, the boys between them have had three fish in the space of probably 20 minutes. There's two in the sack. Each time they've gone to try and photograph them, something's happened. They've now had that one. So we're now going to photograph the one Spud had and ground together, and then photograph G's 42 that he's just had.
Nice little double hook up earlier. Little 25 pound common.
37 pound mirror.
How 42 big was this?
Pounds on the nose.
Yeah, lovely, well done. Yeah, superb G, well done. Spud. Yeah, you must be elated with that. Well, great bit of action, eh?
Third 40 of the trip. Cannot be happier. Yeah, fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
And then you managed to put on one on G's spot.
Put one rod out on G's spot, yeah.
Yeah.
He was having fish after fish after fish. I ain't had one in 10
You finally
days.
Found a G's spot.
Yeah, so I thought, oh, I'm going to stick one out there, and away it went.
Good angling. Cheers, it's mate. Called, where I come from, poaching, but I like it.
It's called that where I come from, but between friends.
Exactly that, yeah. Well done. Well, Thursday night dinner, boys. Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
Well done on your fish today, lads.
Thank you very much.
Well, a most welcome 26 and a half pound mirror. Thursday evening. Heard them boshing over me spot. Come to me other rod to get the angle. And as I did, it went off and carted in. Not a big fish, but I was pleased to have caught it because I probably heard it. So there we go, 26 and a half pound Thursday night.
Yeah, I put that fish back an hour or so ago. Not a big fish, but you know what, it was welcome. Because I was standing by my rods and I could hear the fish rolling. And I can hear them rolling now for the first time. This has been since I've been here. So they're not jumping, they're just rolling right where I'm fishing. So I'm feeling really confident for the night ahead. Really confident. Not loads of fish, but enough to get me excited, that's for sure. Well, Friday morning now, just about to have my first cup of tea. I must confess to expecting a busier night than I actually had. I had a, what I think was a bite on one rod, picked it up, lead was gone, nothing there. So, yeah, that one got away with it. But other than that, yeah, quiet. We'll find out what's happened around the lake in a little while. But, yeah, quiet for the boys too. So, yeah, but to be fair, theirs has been really a day swim. They've had, I think, one bite at night. Everything's during the day for them. But, yeah, let's have a cup of tea, get the world to, put the world to rights. Boys are rebaiting around here in 17. The amount of fish on the graphic. Let's have a look.
Fish everywhere.
Incredible the amount of fish out there. As soon as you get to that spot from there,
That one spot, that, yeah, it literally just fills the screen.
They just like stuck to it, aren't they? Incredible.
I think they know, because obviously there's been bait going on that same spot for the last 2-3 days. Look, they're in there already. Yeah.
Getting liners, no sooner had they baited up and put the rods out. Yeah. How did the boys get on in the corner last night, any idea?
No idea. I think they've had a couple this morning. He's photoing one now.
Yeah, I saw some activity over there early hours of this morning.
Yeah, finally had a fish.
Yeah, well done, Abby.
50 and a half.
Yeah, it's the first fish, a proper one.
Yeah.
Yeah, well done.
Struggling though.
Yeah, he's
struggling. Nick hasn't had anything yet.
Right, and what's happened around the lake?
I think Nick and Bill have had 4 fish last. No, sorry, Bradley and Lewis have had 4. Lewis has done his PB common, 50 something. Nick and Bill have both had a 40 each and a couple of little ones. Oh, Richard the sturgeon is still waiting for his sturgeon.
Yeah, but almost everyone's caught now. But it's all said and done, it's been a slow week, Clay, hasn't it?
Yes.
Apart from the boys here and in 15.
Slow week, but I reckon by the end of the week we'll have all have done 40s. And, you know?
Yeah.
Depends what you come out for. I'll come out just to see you, Kev.
Yeah, you would do. Yeah. Yeah, thanks, Clay. Well, it's nice of you to come around and visit us. Have you bought any food?
No, not yet. No, I've eaten it all.
All right, OK. And the last night, the boys are out for dinner Saturday night. They're going into the town. What? I'm fishing.
All right.
Yeah, but they've got no food for me, so I'll come around for dinner Saturday night. That's kind of you to offer me.
Sorry.
Offer me dinner, Clay. It's really kind. Thanks,
right,
mate.
Right, is it?
Yeah.
All right, you'll have to get some then, because we've got sod all now. We're right down to our last knock-in.
Oh, we've got some grub here.
We're licking paper now. We're licking the containers.
Well, if you stand here long enough, yeah, it won't be long before these go off. Yeah, lunchtime now, Friday. Been up for a shower, done a bit of office work, regroup, get the rods back out. For me, like I was saying earlier, it just seems as though my spots are a nighttime spot. Dead for me during the day, but you know what? Got to get them in the water. So, yeah, let's... got 2 nights to go and I'm still in the zone. I still feel like there's a chance of a big one, that's for sure. So you got to feel like that, you've got to be confident.
Okay.
Oh, Bill.
Yes, mate, not bad.
Tell us how your week's been.
Well, it's been a struggle, mate, but we are nicking a few bites out each evening, getting 1 or 2 bites down in the swim 9, I think we're in, yeah. So we just wait for the evenings to come, they start rolling in, and we're lucky we nick 1 or 2.
And what's been your approach, Bill, you and Nick?
We're just having to go fairly tight in now to the edges, to the get near the snags, and then we tend to get a bite in about 6 to 10 feet of water. Anything out in the 25 seems to struggle for us, even though the guys the other side are actually catching a few out of the 25. We tried it, it just don't seem to work for us.
And what have you had, Bill?
I've had 3 40s now, biggest 42, and a couple of them little channel catfish.
And what about Nick?
Nick's had a 40, a small, about 20 odd pounder, and one of them channel cats as well, and that's been about it. We lost about 2.
And what baiting approach have you used?
We tried everything. We went big on the bait to start with. That never really seemed to pay off, so now we scaled right down. Nick had one on a single hook bait last night, so we're literally just putting a couple of scoops over now on most of the rods and just leaving them. Get them set for about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and then say when the fish come in, we tend to get one.
Oh, Kev.
Right. You, Rich, how are you getting on?
A bit disheartened, mate. It's not like the trip I thought it was going to be honest.
In what way, Rich?
I just thought it was going to be a few more fish for everyone. Didn't think it was going to be like as deep as it is. I got 25 foot all out in front of me, and just not having it. I think they're coming straight past me, going up to Bill and Nick. So, found a bar out in front, but it's a bit out of my swim, so I've been fishing that. With another angler.
Yeah, my swim.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, our swim.
Yeah, our swim.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've had 1 carp, 2 catfish, and 3 sturgeon. So, well, 2 sturgeon, 1 caught 2. But,
and what's been your bait approach?
It's hard to say, really. I mean, I've been trying everything. You know, a little bit of bait, a lot of bait, single baits. Tonight, I'm going to try and bring them into. There's a shelf. As it drops down into the 25, it'll probably be about 20 foot out. So I'm gonna try along that shelf tonight. Last night, really, see what happens.
Yeah.
But equally, it has been a slower week for us compared with, say, last week. But some swims, like this swim and 15 and other swims, are doing typically, Parco well.
That's right,
you know, most of us are struggling, to be fair. Yeah. I think it's just one of those weeks. Could it all change in the next 48 hours.
But it's disappointing for everyone when you drive a long way down to come fish a lake that hopefully it's going to do well. And
yeah, but it's fishing, isn't it? Yeah, you take the rough with the smooth. So. And talking of rough with the smooth, where's Nick?
He's gone down there,
has he?
You see the camera come out.
Yeah, disappeared, done the off. Yeah. He obviously owes you inland revenue money or something.
Yeah, he's got
So I said to the boys when they're going up the supermarket, get me something that I can cook and that's easy to do Saturday night because the boys are going out for dinner. So they bought me some what looks like baby food. Well, it's mid-afternoon Friday and out of the blue, completely out of the blue, had a drop back on my left-hand rod, wound down to it, pulled into what felt like a cracking fish. It's powered away and then snagged. Clayton kindly come over in the boat, went out with my rod for me because I couldn't get into the boat. And fish had put the hook in a snag. Gutted, absolutely gutted. And you know what? I really weren't expecting a bite during the day, but you know what, that's fishing. And just didn't convert it, and boy could I have done with it. Yeah, did feel like a good fish. Mind you know what, they all feel like good fish when you lose them, don't they? But you know, it's like pulling me, you know, it's unbelievable. But anyway, yeah, there you go. Do you know what? These aren't fishy boys, look. I can't even keep the camera straight. He's over there. He come right over here. Well, you could make it up. G, in the last, I don't know, 20 minutes, has had two fish, including another PB. They're both in a sling, trying to get ready to photograph them. His other rod's gone off. So he's now playing that, so he's probably going to have three fish in the slings that we've got to deal with, that is all caught in no time at all. Needed Steve's help. He is. Thanks for your help, Steve. We'd have been knackered without you. Yeah. Good lad. Where's Paul? Is he still up in the swim?
Paul and Mark and Gary are all up there.
Yeah.
I'm glad I landed it, please.
Go on, Steve. Do you want to land that?
My left.
Lovely.
There you go.
Well done, G. How hectic was that?
Well, we sit all day with nothing.
Yeah, he was expecting a hectic.
What do you want to do with him? Put him in.
More busier morning, and then boom.
Yep.
All of a sudden, kicks
off.
That's
a little
20. Let's have a look at what the boys are doing.
Yeah, he's fucking up to something, aren't they?
No, up to something.
They're up to something.
Hey. Look.
If they're Nutty Crunch, you're a different colour than Nutty Crunch I've got.
Ah, see? You're asking too many questions, Steve.
Yeah, they're fucking...
They're not...
They're not normal Nutty Crunch.
Yeah, you and Paul, two of you, Driscoll brothers.
There's something in them. It's secret ingredients.
I think there's no secrets, but between Essex and Hartford, boy, do you know what? Yeah. Richard, right?
Yeah.
I can tell, look, come here, look. Tell me if it's me, right? He's over there. He's coming, I can underarm cast to where he's putting his bait. Yeah. Is that a liberty take or whatever? Unbelievable. There he is there.
Fucking bit of a demon, isn't he?
Isn't he?
Yeah.
Do you know what?
Is that with his eighth rod?
Do you
or his
know
ninth?
What? Under normal circumstances, I'd have gone round there and punched his lights out.
Yeah.
But then I've dawned on it, he looks harder than me.
He's a triathlete.
He is harder than me. Yeah, he's one of the country's fittest 50-year-olds. I'm thinking I'll let him fish there.
He's a determined little fucker.
Yeah, honey.
That's for sure.
Honey. Yeah. Crikey nightmare. Honestly, I think he's where them ducks are.
Yeah.
So you're just putting them £20 back now, aren't you?
Yeah, mate. £20 go straight back.
It's all a bit too hectic for you two, isn't it?
Yeah, no point weighing. When you've got a high 30 and a 50 sat in the sling, there's no point weighing the 20, is there?
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
Photo.
53 and a half.
Yeah,
give me that.
Yep, 53 and a half, buddy, yeah. Yeah, well done.
BB?
Yeah, superb.
BB?
Baby, thank you very, very much.
£52, a pure Italian 24 karat gold.
How good is that, G? Two PBs in one trip.
Fantastic.
Must be well chuffed with that.
Yeah, 53. There, obviously, previously a 49 and a half. And before that, over 10 years ago now, swim bait at Rainbow, 46 and a half. So, yeah, it's been a long time, but.
Yeah, well done.
Yeah, well pleased.
Yeah, so should
well
be.
Well pleased.
Yeah, well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, so G's just put that one back, and we're just now weighing the smaller fish, which is 37 and a half. So yeah, right result. And then he slipped back a 20 pounder. So he had three fish in a space of 20 minutes or thereabouts.
Beautiful colour that one, G.
It is, a real old warhorse.
Yeah, let's go. All that fizzing going on over there, that rod's torn off. It was any second it was going to go, just as we're doing the last fish.
Spuds into that fish, looks a good fish. Well, it's just moving very slow, and it's kited to the right and gone in the same snag G lost one in, I think, this morning or yesterday. So yeah, you can see I'm not filming him now because I think he's probably got other priorities and can do without my camera in his face. So I'm just leaving him to it.
You can feel it, can you?
It's good on, it's kicking still.
Kicking?
I'm half tempted to go swimming.
Well, get a life jacket. Well,
you don't need a life jacket to go swimming for.
Well, it's cold. That looks.
I'm going to strip to me boxers if
right,
I go.
That looks a unit. I ain't being funny. I ain't fucking about. That looked, the way it was moving, Spud. That looked a good fish. Yeah, you can see it kicking the rod tip then. But it's going to be cold, Spud. Yeah.
I'm not fussed about the cold. I'll only be in 5 minutes.
Spud, you're in a dilemma. I was reluctant to have the camera in your face earlier. I could see you was up against it. You seem quite pragmatic now. The fish is on, it's in a snag.
Do I go swimming or don't I?
Are you laughing at Ellis? You're very jealous.
Pump. I'm not getting in that.
That's a lot colder.
I told you.
Than I thought it was.
Yeah, fuck that.
I told you. Yeah.
I don't know what I was expecting. That had warmer earlier. Good bit of footage, Kev.
I don't know about that, but a good bit of footage if we get the fish in. Yeah. Well, I would say, Spud, based on my own experience of going in, is it gets warmer.
Yeah, the longer you stay in it, the warmer it gets.
Yeah, after about 5 minutes.
Yeah, like going down the beach, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, because I do need some video footage. Because we ain't got enough of fish on it, have we, really?
Nah, not yet.
Another thing, you'll probably be alright, because you've got enough fat on you to keep you warm.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, Spud's up there, about, I don't know, 20, 15 yards, and the fish is just to the right of that leaf under the water. Every now and then there's a boil come up just there. That's where the snag is, and that's where the fish is. Richard's kindly coming over with his boat. Give us a hand. Yeah, I think he's got it out. Oh, what a result. That is fantastic. Right, now let's get that fish in.
Yeah, Spud's still out there. The light's fading now. It don't look like it is maybe on the camera, but it is. But yeah, that fish is still on. It's obviously wrapped around a branch or something. And as Richard just said, you know, it's like a rainbow. Sometimes when you get them in and you find that that snag turns out to be a tiny little branch, yeah, it feels like it's a whacking great tree. And but you know, I think his last resort, if I was in that situation, would be just to search for it with the landing net, go down there with the net and like try and scoop it. Because I think if you keep pulling, he's got 15 pound nylon on, it could go. But you know, he's doing his best, and you know, what is me trying to sound all like clever, but you never quite know what best to do. No sooner did you do something and lose one, you wish you hadn't done it. That's how it is, I think. Well, Saturday morning, no sooner had I just taken a sunrise shot, I had a bite on my left-hand rod and got myself what might be a low 30 mirror, which is much needed, given that fish were moving over my spot, same spot, and I had a trailer take out another rod. So, yeah, I'm well chuffed. I'm just going to have a cup of tea. It's in a sling, and, yeah, we'll get it out.
27 and a half this morning, as lively as you like, beautiful fish. I'll have a close up look of it in the sling, it's too lively.
Well, I've come around for a shower and to catch up with Clay and Dick. Dick caught one last night, his first fish, which was much needed. So we'll have a catch up with him and Ash, who's had a particularly good week, and then I'll get back and get the rods out. Yeah, this has been their swim for the week, peg one. I'm just saying, we've had this high pressure all week, not had a breath of wind really on the lake the whole time, but we've had no rain, which is a bonus. Yeah, it's a bonus, because on that note, I'm just saying to the boys, you know, whilst high pressure and no wind and bright sun ain't ideal carpy conditions, it does make for a nicer trip in that you get up in the morning and you ain't confined to your bivvy because it's peeing down with rain and, you know, sideways winds and stuff. But equally, when you do get that, it feels particularly carpy. So, you know, happy medium would be nice. But yeah, as I say, no wind at all this week. But yeah, it is what it is. But yeah, if we continue to look around here in their peg, yeah, a lot of scope out here. There's Nick, who I flew out with over there in three. Two's been empty. And you can see on the map of the lake, there's a what was a road, I think, effectively going down there. That's me over there. And Ash, good call for him. He, you know, no one really fancied this swim, although, you know, my card was marked by someone not to ignore it, and I did. And he's done well just out of this bay, both in open water and over in the far margins. So yeah, good angling on Ash. We'll catch up with him in a little while. Thompson twins, come close.
You reckon?
Thompson twins.
Do you know what, honestly, I didn't believe his age. You look the same age. When he said he was 70, I thought myself, you know what, he's either looking really good and he is, or you're looking
he's
really
10 years
old.
Older than me.
Yeah, unbelievable. Anyway, on that note.
Paint round. Cheers, mate.
Boys, it's Saturday morning, still all to play for, but I'm round here because you boys will be off in the morning driving and one thing and another. Yep. So tell us a synopsis of the week.
Well, it's been a hard week for Parco Standards, hasn't it? We've struggled in one of the top swims, which is not unusual, I suppose, for me, but I think it's been devoid of fish. Seems to be going around the back, missing us completely. But I've had a 50, you had one last
40.
Night.
40, so we've had one blanked. Fish each, definitely not a blank. Nothing worse than a blank. I had one in France this year, I didn't want to have one in Italy, so pretty good. At least we've had a fish.
And do you know what, for the guy who chose the bum swim, and there's me thinking he's blanking all week. You've done all right, didn't you, Ash?
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah, so what'd you end up with, Ash? Not that it's over yet, but what have you had?
61 common, 57 and a half common, and a 53 common. A few grass carp and a couple of channel cats as well.
Yeah, it's a big average size, the carp, then.
Mm.
Yeah, and you was getting them in the middle and the far bank, was you?
Yeah.
And what approach did you have, Ash?
Just loads of boilies, loads of pellet, single pop-up, or wafter on a short rig, about 6 inches, that's it.
Right, yeah.
All on the same.
Yeah, well done. And what made you pick that swim, Ash?
Honestly, it's my mum and dad's house number.
Where have I heard that one before?
So in all seriousness, yeah. Number 22 they live at.
It's funny you say that, because I used to live at 22. Didn't I say to you just now in my story, 22 is my lucky number. I used to live at a 22. Yeah, it's been luckier for you this week, though. Yeah, well done. Yeah, good angle.
It's lucky you didn't count to 22, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, nice one. So you're back here next year, next October?
Next October, yeah. Looking forward to that. We've got a couple of weeks earlier than this one, so...
And is there anything you'd do differently, Clay, in nothing terms of all. What your approach this week?
Nothing at all. No? There'd be a lot of people that disagree with that.
I don't know anything else.
Yeah.
No, I think you've just, you know, if you're on the fish, I mean, for Parco standards, it's not really sort of excelled, but we've got 7 people on this trip that have done PBs. Two or three people that have done 3 or 4 times over, you know, so on this trip. So if someone had said that to me before we set off, 6 people are going to do their PBs, I'd have been
fair call. Yeah, all right then, boys, thanks for that. So let's have me your fried egg bacon sandwich now, egg over easy, and I'll get back.
Right, we need to have a little chat again.
A right load of herbers, didn't I?
We've got Bill, Nick and Lou. So morning. I'll start with you, Lou. Give us a synopsis of your week.
So we've had a 55 mirror PB for me, 61 common for my fishing partner Bradley, PB for him. Been a bit slow, but been good fish, good quality fish.
Yeah, good average size there.
Yeah, good.
Good for you. And how was you getting them? What was your approach?
I'm just out in mid-water really, not really having too much of a better bait, but just, yeah.
Fishing for a bite?
Nicking a bite, right, that's it, exactly that.
And did you have a lot of fish moving down there? Because you're at the far end on the... What peg were you in?
We were in 6. Right. Yeah, a lot of movement at night, a lot of movement.
Yeah.
The quieter nights, when it weren't so busy on top of the water, that's when you was nicking the fish out.
Right, yeah. Yeah, no, well done. And what about you two then, boys? How would you sum up the week so far?
It's been a bit of a tough week, isn't it, really? It's been very frustrating. There's a lot of fish down our end, but they're basically not interested in going down to eat the bait, and we're having to pick them up in the margin, so which is hard work because we're losing as many as we're getting in, and we seem to be getting a lot of catfish as well.
Yeah, I mean, in the what seems to happen in the evenings, the fish definitely push down to our bit because we don't see much in the day, and me and Nick are sharing the rods, like taking it in turns. So normally what happens is, like, Nick will catch one and then I'll then put my rigs on, and then I'll catch one within about 10 minutes. And then I'll put his rigs back on, and we have to wait about 36 hours.
Can't swear on a camera, but.
So I've only really had about 10 minutes rod time at the moment.
So, what have you caught then between you?
Well, we've had 4 40s and one about sort of up a 20, something like that. We've had a load of little catfish and loads of weird occurrences. I think there's probably a few fish trailing a bit of line about. So, you do tend to get a lot of sort of weird things going on with the rods and stuff, but
it's been so frustrating, the fact that there are fish jumping down there all the time and you just can't seem to catch them. It's been a difficult week.
And what's been your approach bait wise
well, we've tried all sorts of things. We tried bags, we tried method balls, we tried bigger beds of bait, we tried little scoops of bait, we've been putting out with a boat, we've been casting it, and it don't really seem to be any particular method that was working any better than the other. I mean, I had a 40 pound common the other night on a single boilie that chucked out on the edge.
And what peg was you in?
Peg 9.
And if you was coming back, say you was coming back in a couple of weeks, what would you do differently?
I don't know. I think you just got to assess every situation as it comes along. Probably come out better in the draw, I think, would probably be. Yeah. I mean, yeah. I think the draw was key. If you had got top 3, we probably would have got one of the prime swims. If we had come out a little bit higher than what we did, we would have probably got our backup swim, which was where Ash is, and he's had a 60 and a couple of 50s. But it's just been a tough week. It's been a real head banger. But we've had some nice food. We've had a good laugh, haven't we? A few bottles of wine.
And we've still got tonight to go and stuff.
I mean, you can't knock the stamp of fishing.
Unbelievable.
We reckon, say for instance, 80 fish have been out, probably 50% have been over 40 pounds.
Yeah.
I mean,
everyone's had a 40 apart from Richard, you know, and he's had 2 50 pound sturgeon. So, admittedly, the same one and the same one that Clayton had. Oh, hang on, and the same one that Mark had, but it's still a 50 pound sturgeon twice. It's been a good week, and the place is phenomenal. I mean, the size of the fish in here, three or four 60s out this week,
and the amount of fish in here, everyone's had fish all over the lake jumping in front of them at some stage, aren't they?
Tonight, because it's the final night, I'll let him use my rigs and hopefully we'll get
see if he can turn it around.
It'd be good, because he's got at least three hooks per rig, so he's got at least triple the chance of catching.
All right,
on
boys.
The bottom, one on the top.
Okay, cheers, thanks for that. Cheers, guys. You've been able to swim 15 minutes and you've had three.
Yeah, been a bit of a hectic morning.
All three rods went, did they?
No, we only got two out. One rod went, it was banked in the net, and then we put the other two rods out, and they've both gone.
Both
Jay and I have been hauling again.
Yeah, lovely.
Fantastic.
Yeah, we'll have a look at
them. Well, it's lunchtime Saturday, and this is, probably the best day we've had for fishing, in that we've got some breeze, it's overcast, it's mild, it looks really good. So I'm feeling confident of a bite in the day. Yeah, although I had a bite in the day yesterday, I lost it, I think. Yesterday, don't know if I mentioned it on camera, mid-afternoon out of the blue, but right now feels really good. But the boys are having it off. Fisher on that echo sounder, you can see them everywhere. Unbelievable the amount of fish that are holding in that area this the last few weeks. Incredible. Well, the boys have got three in the sling. Each time they go to get them ready, it goes off again. Geez, just had another bite. I keep saying it, they've photographed one fish, a small one, and no sooner had they went to get another sling out, it's tore off again for G. Spud can't buy a bite. Are they still moving in front of you, Steve?
Well, Paul said he had... Paul up there ain't had love. How about you, George? You doing all right, are you? Isn't it?
Oh! Oh, it was a long, hard fight, that one. But yeah, another nice fish.
The whole lot in one hit.
What?
Outweigh it, photograph it.
Say that again.
45.5 pounds of pure gold.
£33 on the nose, just as I was packing up.
Well, it's 7:20 Saturday. The boys have packed up. They're going into the town. They've had a great week. They're going to have an early night, have a dinner, get a good night's kip. They've got a long drive home tomorrow. I'm fishing till 7:00 in the morning, all to play for. So, fish are moving between me and Richard. More in front of me, but Richard's come over like he does, but we're all mates, Rich. Yeah, it's another Turkish you owe me. There's fish between me and him, so I'm confident one of us will get a fish, or both of us, or maybe more than one. But right now, all to play for, have a cup of tea, have an early night myself. I'm flying back tomorrow afternoon, but you know, we've got 12 hours to make it happen.
Just packing up, and the rod, to be fair, that I put in the boys' swim has gone off, as it was always going to, first thing in the morning. Oh, well pleased with that. It's about, I think, approaching 8:00 now, Sunday morning. Got a skirt about, and got a fish in there, probably mid-20. But you know what? I'm well happy. Cool. Here we go. Last fish of the trip. Well, it's Monday lunchtime, and the boys are back, having travelled overnight from the lake. So they've kindly dropped the gear off, having took it down for me. I had the pleasure of flying back. They look absolutely knackered. But what a week these two boys had, as did others. So, start off with you, G. Give us a synopsis in the space of a minute or so of the week.
Parco del Brenta is an amazing lake. It's got a huge head of very, very big fish, which aren't that difficult to catch. Well, they can't be, because I caught some.
and quite a few. You don't need any particular skills, any particular tackle, just very basic stuff. But it's a beautiful lake in a beautiful setting. You know, you can't go wrong. It's not as expensive as you think it is once you break it down and work out the costs of fishing other lakes. And yeah, I'd definitely recommend anyone, you know, get a group of you together. If you can get three sets of gear in one van, it does help. Although next year we're having two in a van only. You know, so it'd take a bit more bait or whatever. But yeah, happy days. You know, it'll suit virtually all types of angling.
All right, you, Spud. Tell us a bit more about your approach.
I've done a bit of research when we went out there. They use a lot of pellet out there and do it by feeder fishing. So obviously we took a bit of advice on with that. Went out there with a lot of pellet and a lot of feeders. Weren't having a fish at mega long range. I think we're fishing at 60, 70 yards tops. Just scalding pellet down, moulding it around the feeder. And it seemed once you got one area going, you just couldn't go wrong. Just put the rod in there and within 10 minutes they were going. But some lovely fish in there, some absolute huge fish in there as well. For me, it's been an absolutely blinding week. Smashed my PB by about 30 odd pounds, so can't grumble. Superb place.
And you too, G, you had your PB twice.
Yes, I was very, very lucky. I had the same PB for about 12 years now. It was back at Rainbow in 2005, 46 and a half pound mirror carp from Swim 8. Hadn't come anywhere close to that for, say, ever since. And then to get a 49 and a half pound, and then a 53 and a half pound was absolutely fantastic. Really, really special week. Really enjoyed it. You know, great, great, great bunch of boys.
Yeah, and I'll just add to that in saying, yeah, it was a great week. And, you know, look forward to going back. The boys are back there next October. I'm not scheduled to go. We've got to thank Clay for arranging it. All the Hertfordshire boys, new faces that we met as well. So, yeah, cracking time. And, yeah, well done to you boys. You fished well. Yeah, right. Fished hard, fished well. Cheers, you know, others done well as well. Yeah. Anyway, that's a wrap now. The boys are going home, have a shower and shave and sleep and everything else. I'm going to get into the office, get on with some work, and yeah, thanks all for watching. And again, thanks to the lads and to the lake, you know, to the Parco guys that run it, you know, doing a great job, and we look forward to coming back. Cheers, guys.
Sinking pina colada. I heard a dark voice beside me say, would you like something harder? She said, I've got it.